Well, don't burst a blood vessel, Trebles. Don't want anybody blowing up.
No shouting, no screaming, and no sharpening.
And try not to change the language of the beast unless given strict instructions so to do.
Again.
When I remember that time, it was wanting to do something different, be something different, anything but what I was doing, anybody but who I was.
Troubles again?
For 5 years, 3 times a week for practice and twice for service on Sunday, I worked as a choir boy. I was 15, still with that voice. I was head chorister, chief soloist, and waiting for my life to start.
Come on, open your mouths again.
I was glad.
Where have you been, Slater?
I had a puncture, sir.
I'll puncture you, Slater.
Let's hear it, Troubles.
I was glad.
What's the stress worth, Hindle?
Glad, sir.
Is it a woman's name, Hindle?
No, sir.
Well, what does it mean, then, Note?
It means I was happy, sir.
You don't sound so puzzled, Noakes. What are we glad about, choir captain?
We're glad because we're going to Blackpool, sir.
Don't push your luck, Slater.
No, sir.
And what are we going to do when we get to Blackpool, Slater?
We're going to sing, sir.
Superbly, Slater. And that means practice, Slater. It means punctuality, Slater. No punctures.
It'll get worse as the week goes on. From the A tempo, please, Mr. Lentil.
Now, come on. We've got more anthems to get through. Open those mouths from A. Nice, open bowels. Bowels, Lentil. Bowels. And I bet you're early.
Troubles. Choir.
Back troubles at the front.
Oh, you look like a tent slayer.
It's the pretty boy then.
Chief face off, boy.
Grease ball.
Well, I know sprung a leak.
Oh, what are you laughing at, White?
You. Where are we?
Front. A reddish.
Doubt, that's our place.
Oh, Christ, if I'm not at the front, I'm going to be sick.
And you've got orange round your mouth, reddish.
Well, don't take it out on him.
I hate this bloody journey.
What's up with you?
Nothing.
Tommy won't like it.
What?
The gear.
Yeah, well, Tommy can fart.
Hindle's not here yet.
I know.
Where's Noakes?
He's gone with Tommy.
Creep.
Yes, thank you. Thank you very much, everybody. Oh, no, no, please, fans, please. This is a religious outing.
How many are you buried today, then?
Oh, just the one. Cremation. Much cleaner. Well, well, well. Where did you get that jacket from?
Oh, don't you start.
Thanks, Dad.
Is that a straw hat, sir?
An Italian straw hat. Well packed, Note.
I think that's about it, sir.
Yeah, apart from your case. It will fit in, won't it?
On the camp bed, sir.
Good God, Noakes, what is it?
Well, it's a camp bed, sir. My father's. He had it in the army. Africa, sir.
Well, where are you going to put it? It's not going to fit in there.
I could try the other side.
Ram it, no.
We're all going on a journey.
What's yours?
You know, every crest, I think. These look like dripping.
Each year, the choir went to Blackpool, Tommy's little outfit. By night, we were praised for the excellence and purity of our singing. The rest of the time, we did what boys and youths have always done at a place like Blackpool a quarter of a century ago. In a small way, I suppose, we were a holiday attraction.
It's gold time, John.
Lentil was assistant organist, Tommy's faithful adjutant. As a boy, he'd sung at the coronation, a voice once famous. He had a stutter when he spoke, was fine when he was singing, and, because he wasn't Tommy, was a figure of fun to us.
Hello, Tony. Is your father in?
No.
Has he left us the keys? Your indicator's still out.
It's ready. She's not feeling too good, so he says.
Yeah, well, he's been stuffing his face into a sty. Before we sty.
Trips, sir.
Women? What women in it? What for?
First aid, cooking, that kind of thing, sir.
It's not the field tent, it's Qatari, Hendel. We have the aspirins. Mr. Lentil's cooking is perfectly good enough for me. Who's women?
Just a suggestion, sir.
Where would they sleep, Hendel, these women?
Here, sir.
Nose down hygienic. Any more suggestions, Hendel?
Just a thought, sir.
Yeah, well, try not to confuse the younger boys, Indle. Yeah, ah, Slater. Come here. Approach the presence. What do you call this, Slater?
Call it, sir?
Your dress, Slater.
It's called gear, sir.
Well, I'm not happy about it. Do you intend to wear those shoes for the service, Slater?
Oh, you can't see them, sir. Not underneath my cassock.
Not see those toes? Well, what do you call them, Slater?
They're called semi-winkle pickers, sir.
I see.
Have you got any others?
No.
Well, don't sulk, Slater. We can borrow somebody else's. And I want that hair washed out. It's not appropriate, and you know it. We're on show, but it's not a fashion show. You understand? We don't want to distract the customers, Slater.
Right. Get my dancing shoes, Revel. They're in the car. Rehearsals in 10 minutes.
Revel, sleep here. Both sides. You're on the stage. Slater's up in that top corner. Lindell has that room there.
This is the best position.
Why?
First of the bogs in the morning.
Ah, afternoon, Vicar. Everything under control, Tom?
Yes, I think so, thank you.
Need a Milo pump ready.
Hey, that's my place.
Who says?
The deputy chorister always sleeps there.
Not according to Slater, he wants me in. Ask him, not me.
Come along, first Baptista, clear the way.
Thank you.
Are you sleeping in this year, sir?
No, at the vicarage, Revel. I shan't be far away.
Why? I just wondered, sir.
I'll be within earshot, Revel.
Hey, where am I sleeping this year?
Sleep where you like.
Well, we were up the far end last year.
Yeah. Well, that was last year.
Well, that space has always been for
head chorister and deputy head chorister.
Yes. What's the matter with you anyway?
Nothing.
Well, don't you want me there?
No, not particularly. No.
What, because I've got a lovely Tommy this year?
No, you just leech around people, Noakes.
It's only because he's fed up of you.
Come on, gentlemen. Breakfast. Do I have any requests, gentlemen?
What's Conway?
Not man enough.
Let's have the lid up, White. Come on, boys, bring your chairs round pronto.
Tony, the vicar's son is back!
Got a bit tall last week because they think I'm too young for it.
What, the cops?
Yeah.
Have you left school then?
Yeah, I'm finished here now. Bingo caller, part-time.
Do these things have gears? What is it?
It's French.
Is that where you were last year?
Summer holidays. Yeah. Got packed off to a monastery, youth workers' church camp, that sort of thing. Didn't do no good. You the main man now?
Yeah, something like that.
The boss man?
Yeah, that's me.
Yeah, have a go. There's nobody around.
God, if I have brakes, I'd be bloody lethal.
Noakes to him.
Where?
Why didn't he take those shoes off? Clod off, isn't he? Oh, well done, Noakes. Poor boy. He gets so confused sometimes. Slater's voice is beginning to go. He was straining on the top notes this morning and just began to hear it.
Few months left in it, surely.
Perhaps. He's not the boy he was. He's not the influence he was.
Noakes can replace him.
Do you think so?
He's very good.
Yes, well, I'll keep it under review. Yeah, we've got too few stars at the moment. It's not the same as it was in your day. Sanderson. Himself. Chatterton. You've got plenty of team players, a very good thing too, but it limits your room for manoeuvre.
Nobody's sitting here, is there?
No.
It's hot, isn't it? Well, I'm hot. Do you know who you remind me of? Christine Keeler. That's who I thought you were. Yeah, but don't get me wrong. I think she's very attractive.
Are you a comedian? Sam's hotel, please.
Certainly, please. I'm a singer, actually.
Yes, please.
To stop at St. Stephen's.
Yes, totals, please.
I know what you're thinking. My mother, she doesn't like them on me either. But I say to her, your eyesight's important. Of course, I don't wear them on stage.
far you ever got with a girl?
Number four.
Number four? Liar.
What do you mean, liar?
You have never got to number four. Who?
I'm not talking about it.
That's because you've never done it.
I have.
Who?
Jane Daish.
You're meant to be a choir boy. You're meant to be pure, you.
Yeah. What about you, then?
Me? Five and a half.
What's five and a half?
You know what four is? You know what five is? What's five and a half? Just think about it.
I am thinking about it.
What's five? What's six?
All the way.
So what's five and a half?
A flop. Well, I don't know.
God, you're meant to be the brain box around here. It's getting it in.
Yeah. Well, what's the point of that?
What's the point if any of it comes to that? People get pregnant, you know. A bit of education for you.
Yeah, I know. I know.
Hey, Piers, do us a good place when you finish, will you? Well, it's more than you've ever done.
Done what I've done? You've not been all the way. Don't come that with us.
Who said I had? Hey, did you win this?
Yeah.
You actually won something worth winning.
Yeah, he didn't look too pleased about it either.
I bet he didn't. I'll buy it off you.
Get lost. Get your own.
Come on, how much?
27 and 6. They're all 27 and 6.
You're 25.
You must be joking. You've got more money than me, Hindle. Oi.
Do you reckon I look like him?
Not a lot, no.
I want to be famous. I want to be rich. I want to shag lots of women. Well, I'm going to take all my clothes off.
Practices on corpses, is it?
How do you impress somebody, eh, Rev? Well, talk to me.
What, apart from changing your complete personality?
Apart from that, yes.
You could try putting blue black on your balls.
Do you have a noble staying here? The name Noble? Miss A. Noble?
Yes, we have. Are you a friend? Shall I ring up for
no,
you?
No. I'd like to leave with this, please. Sorry, I've no solitaire.
What name shall I say, sir?
Mr. McCartney. Mr. P. McCartney. Small C, then large C. Thank you.
Breakfasted. A mister, dirty postcard.
It's from my parents, sir. They're on holiday.
Come on, come on. It's taking all the time now.
Hey, give me first.
Who is it?
Who's he?
Dunno.
Reddish, I think.
Oh, I've got to follow his son. Come on, Reddish. Whatever you're doing in there, hurry up and die in.
Yes, well, don't trample over everybody, White.
I've got some posts for you.
What's up?
Maybe it's not your birthday today, is it?
No. It's my gran. She always gets a day, Sean. 15 tomorrow. Soon be legal.
Getting to be an old man, eh?
My wish for you this special time is love and happiness be thine.
Nope, it's time you got up, Revel.
Up, come on!
How can I get up, eh?
So to speak.
That's not the problem.
Are we talking about lift-off here?
You could say that, yeah.
Ah, you dirty boy. You should wear gym jams.
I need a piss. How do I get anywhere near a boat?
Come on, Revel. False modesty.
It's your glands. Tell you what I'll do. I'll close the curtains, you sell me the record.
What have you done with it, Indo? Where is it?
He wants a date.
He wants to do what?
He wants to meet me at the hotel.
To do what?
Dunno. Take me out.
Tonight?
Yeah.
You met him on a tram?
Yesterday. He's harmless.
How old is he?
17.
You want to be careful of 17-year-olds.
Don't worry, Dad. He's a singer.
A group?
O Lord, open thou our
lips. And the mouth shall show forth thy praise.
You're sharpening trebles. It's William Byrd, not Schoenberg. Again.
O Lord, open thou our lips.
And the mouth shall show forth thy praise.
Better. Tenors, you're beginning to drag a bit. You're groaning, you're all blunt. And get a cleaner noise on that low E flat. Clean it up. Now, let's have more urgency rather than we've got all morning to do it.
O Lord.
Oh, yes, that's charming notes. Yes, that's very nice.
Only not too much religious fervour. Would you like to take over? It's the flesh pots, nooks. They're affecting your brain, that tiny pea brain. Now, come on! Snap to it, choir! Now, Gloria!
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the
Holy. How were the boys last night?
There was a fair bit of whisper on talking. Pretty well behaved, I think. I went to sleep finally. Can't do that for full 8 hours.
That's a quiet cup of tea. The boys did just give you.
Why not?
I don't know how to put this. Vicar has asked me out tonight. Three
Peter's got plans.
Flesh pots?
Oh, I don't. It's an organ recital.
Where?
Oh, I don't know.
I don't want to lumber you, though.
You mean the boys might play off if they thought you were gadding round?
Mm. First you tell them.
Oh, well, that's all right, then.
What's the matter?
Can't find the keys.
Oh, milk shop, anyway. Look, I won't go if it bothers you.
No, no, no. Oh, well. Join the fray.
You ought to get out in the town a bit.
And you worry too much.
Oh, no. I'm an old fuddy-duddy.
I must be the first altar boy ever to have been knocked down by a priest during communion. My dad, he just got mad at me. It's true.
Oh, in the service?
Yeah. I spat in the chalice.
What for?
It was after my mother died. A protest, like.
What, to God?
Something like that, yeah. My dad, he just went for me. Says he was under strain. Never again. He don't bother me these days, and I don't bother him. I go my own way.
My penis in blue jeans.
Give me a prat.
Is it? Let's have it. Dirty book.
What is it?
Bloody pages are falling out. What have you been doing, picking up tips?
I've only read this bit about three times. God, I'm listening.
What's it about?
The clitoris. God, it's complicated. It's like motor maintenance.
Let's have a look.
Puts you off even trying.
He's got a woman, isn't he? He's got a date.
Yeah, if she turns up. And if I'm out late, Slater, you tell him I got relatives staying or something, will you?
Yeah, right. God, you do creep around, though.
What's going off?
Nothing. Just keep your nose out of it.
Curfew?
Yeah, something like that.
So you're subject to his every whim, are you?
Well, he's going out tonight anyway.
Who?
Tommy. He's going out with your dad. I heard him talking to Lentil this morning.
Till when?
Dunno. Keeping it quiet. Going to a concert or something.
That's a bit sneaky, isn't it? Here, does anybody know about Tommy?
No.
Keep it quiet then, all right? So what are you doing tonight then?
Pinball. Nothing much.
Well, let's get out then.
Hey, don't!
You'd go berserk if you didn't have a laugh pissing around with this lot. I'll give you something to look back on.
Yeah, all right.
Is there anything I can do? Just call on me and I'll send it with love from me to you. I got everything that you want.
Right to the edges, Reddish. There's a good boy.
Tea in the large tin, Parker. Fill the kettle from the hot water thing or it takes ages to boil.
Hope you've been keeping Slater away from the flesh pot, Sindel.
Sir, I was wondering about tonight, sir. My parents, they're here in Blackpool.
Oh, your parents? They come to listen to us?
I don't know, sir. They're staying down by the South Pier. They want to take us out for a meal, sir.
Us?
Me and Slater, sir. You see, it's his birthday tomorrow, but they're going back. We wondered about tonight, sir.
Well, how long do you need, Endel? Planning a 7-course banquet, are you?
No, sir. Half an hour. An hour extra, sir.
10 o'clock, prompt. The boys were tired this morning. I want them in early tonight. I don't want you disturbing them when you come in.
Yes, sir.
Requires me. Sir, is it Stafford and G tomorrow?
Yes.
Hooray!